TK Maxx Snack
Review
for you.
And what shall I review today?
Cocktail candy, whiskey and cola, boiled sweets. Now I've had these for a while. And they was actually reduced twice in TK Maxx. They just couldn't shuff them. They just couldn't. So, anyway, then along comes me, and I buy them. And there was originally £6.99, then they were reduced to £4, and then £3. I thought, oh, well, I do this series on TK Maxx, so I might as well just get them. And it's only really occurred to me today that picking them up, there's a strange gap. And what can only be described as sellotape along the lid. Do you know what this is now occurring in my brain after this massive delay? It's as if some old drunk in Hammersmith has gone into TK Maxx, burglarised a boiled sweet, and put them back on the shelf. Then Muggins here goes into TK Maxx in Hammersmith, picks it up and thinks, ooh, what a bargain. They've reduced it twice when about a couple of them are missing. They've also set rock solid as well. Now I've got to try and pick off this sellotape. And oh, it's really stuck on. Oh, there it is. I think that's the end. And I think it's been put on some by somebody who's maybe left-handed because it's on a weird way. So I'm going to have to try and peel this off. After a good couple of minutes, I've taken off the sellotape. Let's see. And the lid still opens well. Oh, that effing stink. Oh, that smells horrible. Oh. Oh. I've done a lot of bar work and I've worked in a few nightclubs as well, and this actually smells when you first walk in on a Saturday night before the bar's ready to open. That horrible stale boozy pukey sort of smell. Oh my word, someone's actually been able to bottle that smell. Oh, it's rank. Oh. Now I'm going to have to try and peel one off. I think the person who stole it didn't actually like puke all over it as well, or burp into it or something. Because that is really bad. Oh my god, they've actually set rock hard. Well, there's a loose one. Let's pop this in my trap and see what it tastes like. Incredibly sharp on the tongue because they've all got stupid angles on them. Which is the last thing you want in a boiled sweet. So I can't press my tongue against it just yet because I don't want to stab through the roof of my mouth. I've replaced the lid. Some of them have managed to completely shatter at the bottom of the bottle, look. Is it a bottle? It is a bottle, isn't it? Now, the taste. By the way, it does contain real alcohol. It's got it in brackets. But it does say, well, there's pictures in so you can see what's in it and what's not in it. Ingredients: sugar, glucose syrup, water, malic acid, whiskey, and cola flavouring. Then it's whiskey at the very end, but just above colours E153 and E171, which I'm just about to investigate what colours they are. Well, I've been sucking and researching, and E153 is carbon black, and E171 is titanium dioxide. There we go. And as I've been sucking and researching, I've also been in slight pain. Because, as with all boiled sweets, oh, the black's all gone. It's leaving really sharp bits where the it looks like a tooth, doesn't it? You know what I mean? That looks a bit. Can you see the sharp bits in there? Now, they might not look sharp on the camera, obviously, but put that in your mush, and it is. Ugh. It actually looks like a tooth. Hiya. Yeah. This is my tooth. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please subscribe, let me know in the comment section down below if you like whiskey and cola flavoured boiled sweets. But these absolutely stink. The taste of them is a bit like stale whiskey. It tastes a bit like it's been left out. Once again, I've worked in bars and restaurants and a few nightclubs, and if you don't put the lid on, this is what it tastes like and smells like. They're not very enjoyable, but I suppose really old people who remember flavours from the 1920s, 30s or something might like them, but I find them absolutely vile. I do not like these. Anyway, thanks for watching Scrass, and I'll soon see you. Bye.
Bye.